My woman, gonna take this rhythm to my friends, gonna take this rhythm to my family. We're playing a groove that never bends, and it never ends.
My theory about recording a record is that, number one, it's a snapshot of where I am at that time in my life, number one. And number two, this is really important, I really don't want to make records, my own music, with people that I don't have a deep and long-term musical relationship with. So just calling in a guy, you know, out of the blue, I've never really done that. You know, however famous they may be, that's not the way I want to operate. I want to use people that I can really, really communicate with, you know, mentally, musically, every way. Can I play?
And I have spent a lot of time in the studio together. This is his fourth studio album we've done together. Carl has always been prepared, and I think that's the studio musician in him. While that may sound like a mechanical process, he makes it a lot of fun.
Alrighty, roll it.
So my producer, good friend, recording engineer Mark Hornsby, played me a record that he had produced and mixed on Danley speakers down in Nashville. He said, you got to hear these speakers. And so they actually shipped a pair out to LA, and we hooked them up in my little home studio, and they blew my mind. I've made a living in the studios for many, many years, and I really know what these studios sound like. And I know what my sound sounds like in these studios. And so it was really cool to go out there into the room, adjust an amplifier, get it sounding exactly like I want, and then come back in and hear it over the Danleys. It was super inspiring.
I'm a bass player, so I'm always listening for my parts, of course, the low end, and the accuracy and the separation between the bass and the kick. And one of the things I noticed about the speakers was that for smaller speakers, just lots of low end, but super accurate and with a lot of definition.
So speaking as a drummer, I'm always looking for a speaker to sound like the way the drums sound when I'm behind them playing. And so these speakers sound very, very natural. More specifically, what I'm looking for is the kick drum, does it sound really punchy without being colored at all? And I found that these speakers really produced a very, very honest sound, which I absolutely love.
There was definitely a very special quality about the clarity and separation. It was just a joy. It was like sonic heaven.
Danley speakers are refreshing to listen to. The low end sounds amazing. The top end is crystal clear. One of the most important things of mine and Carl's production process is what we hear in the studio needs to be what we hear outside of the studio. What I love about this home series that you're looking at behind me is you see this natural wood finish. When you look at it, there's a simplicity to it. But if you take the back off of that cabinet, There's a lot of moving parts going on behind the scenes. I've listened to stuff on these speakers that I've recorded in New York, London, Abbey Road, Miami, Nashville, the rooms that I've spent hours in. And listening to the playback of those tracks on these speakers, it really feels like I'm sitting in the room where I recorded these tracks. That's very emotional, to play something back and you have this sensation that you're right back where you were when you recorded it. That's priceless.
And the word from this rocky shore, we're going home somehow. And I've heard the starboard side, there's an open door. Yes, they're gonna deliver you and I.
I've got the usual degree of festivals coming up, so I hope to just get out there and play all this music for the rest of the year. It's really fun to play.